This is the 2.4 engine from Kia and Hyundai, and I did replace the oil, so I want to share with you the amount that it takes. So I had this 5-liter jug, 5-liter, I'll let you convert in quarts. On the side here it shows quarts and liters, so use the liter scale, I think it's easier. And what I did pour 4 liters, so down to the 1 mark, 4 liters, and did run the engine so the oil got inside the oil filter. With 4 liters, I got the oil to be at the low mark on the dipstick. So right there, 4 liters with the filter filled up with oil as well. And then I added another 0.5 liter. So the jug now has 0.5 liter remaining. And that 0.5 liter got me to the full mark. So it seems in between the low, full, or if you want min max, there is 0.5 liter or 0.5 quart. And if you want to top it out to full, it's 4.5 liters, at least on my car, 4.5 liters to get to the full mark. After you run the engine, you fill the oil filter as well with engine. You need to really make sure the car is very, very level in both axes. So right, like this, like that. Be careful, I'm in a mall parking spot, and parking spot are all times are kind of inclined just to drain the rainwater. So be careful when you choose your spot. And it's also better to let the car rest overnight. You are going to get a easier reading, especially when the oil is new. It's very difficult to see it on the dipstick. And my last tip, you see this side of the dipstick with min, max, low, full. Put this side of the dipstick towards the center of the car. So just grab it like this with the reading. You see the reading at the top, and that's how you insert it. I recommend don't try to insert it the other way. So with the reading at the top, that's how you get it in there. Make sure you have the letters at the top, like this, not like this. Because sometimes when you remove it, it will show a long smear on the other side. It looks like there's higher level of oil on one side. That's why you want to get the reading like this at the top. You see the reading marks, and you read only on the reading side, not on the other side, because the other side gets smeared with oil from the dipstick tube. So it's confusing. So just make sure you read on the correct side, and you put the correct side at the top like this. This is the owner manual, and I don't recommend Quaker State. Anyhow, 2.4, they have the total volume of oil 4.8 liters. This is the liters, and this is the quarts. Just about 4.8, that would consider perhaps at the max level on the dipstick, but 4.8, it's also including the oil that remains trapped maybe around the engine or the top of engine head, some other places too. You cannot really drain the entire oil. Also, you will have oil smearing the surface of inner surfaces, inner volumes. So that cannot be drained even if you let the car sit all night draining. So you are not going to remove 4.8. And for this reason, I don't recommend you try to pour in 4.8 after draining your oil. There will still be some amount remaining in there. So just my advice, try with 4.5. I'm not sure, just make a conversion in quarts if you use quarts, but the jugs, at least in Canada, well, yeah, the jugs also show quarts. So try to pour 4.5. Let it sit, better let it sit overnight, but just run the engine so you get the oil inside the oil filter as well, unless you just pre-fill the oil filter. If you pre-fill the oil filter, just make sure you use no more than 4.5 liters overall. So just try with 4.5, run the engine a couple of seconds, 10-20 seconds, make sure the oil circulates inside, then let sit the car really, really, and I'm really stressing on this, on level surface. The tiniest incline will vary a lot on these engines, the level on the dipstick. So, and then just measure again the oil after at least 1 hour sitting or so, and just adjust for if you want. But I think at 4.5, you are going to be close to the max level, just maybe slightly below max level, and it's just safe so you don't overfill
Don't pour 4.8, you may be overfilling. Now, the reason actually I did make this video is the dipstick volume, if you want, between the low and the max marks, or min max marks. This is what the manual says, and it's just not good, because there are many cars where the difference between min and max is actually 1 liter, and not in, on this engine is really different. It's about maybe half a liter or so. So they don't just don't tell you. That's just not good. This is a miss in this book. And maybe you did notice that this min max bar doesn't even correspond with the actual min max points on the dipstick. The picture printing, this bar came just offset, lower than it should have been. Should have been sitting higher here. That's the same on all three pictures. No one checked this booklet at the printing. When you refill, always make sure you use a funnel. And let me just put one last detail, tell you something. I actually had my new jug with oil, and I did measure a full jug, and I did measure an empty jug, the plastic weight. And the jug was really, really close to 5 liters. So the amount in the jugs, oil jugs, I guess all brands, it's very close to what says on the sticker. So I would say, don't worry, it's not more or less than what's on the sticker. Maybe it's varying by 50 milliliters or so, which is really not much. But the jugs really have the exact amount on the stickers. Small tip, whenever you check your oil, always look for tiny particles of metal. Could be silver, could be gold, right into the oil on the dipstick. Just look closely. Let me show you engine wear. It's just preventative a little bit, so you know in advance when your engine will blow. Make sure, don't forget to check your oil every month, at least every month.